It is a clean product. If you go on Sephora, they will do that clean stamp where you know that it is formulated without a lot of the nasties that can potentially be irritating to the skin. When I research certain ingredients and I'm like, it's a neurotoxin or this is a hormone disruptor.
So what is the junk? What are these neurotoxins that she's talking about? What is the nasties? I wonder if we should recreate Tati's skincare routine, but make it affordable, cruelty-free, and not clean. Do we want a dirty version of Tati's skincare routine? Tati Westbrook's monthly skincare routine costs around $1,000. And if you have that kind of money to spend on skincare, more power to you. But some of us would like some affordable, cruelty-free, and even some drugstore or vegan alternatives that don't cost as much, but that still do great things for our skin. So you know me, your acne big sister, resident medical esthetician, and pesticide drinker, aka coffee connoisseur, has decided to put together a list of Tati Westbrook's skincare dupes. Basically, the products that are similar enough or have active ingredients comparable to what she spends for $147 for a face mask, but at literally fractions of the price. Because I believe you should not have to spend ridiculous amounts of money for a good skincare routine. And I know that Tati actually spoke about her fear of drugstore products.
I will admit, because of the skin journey that I've been on and because I don't want to regress into breaking out, and my skin can tend to get clogged and break out pretty easily, I do have a hard time trusting some of the drugstore products out there.
So after hearing that, when doing our reaction video to her skincare routine, and after reading your comments about actually wanting this video, yes, I have taken the time, I have read the ingredients lists, I have turned and learned and scrutinized and analyzed to bring you one of the most difficult videos I've worked on in quite a while. This took multiple people and many man hours to try to find products that are either dupes or comparable. And before we start talking about the Caudalie and the $147 face mask and the $26 doll hair dupe, I do have to say that dupe culture in general is anything but perfect. Some of these products are not going to be identical dupes when it comes to ingredients or formulation. And speaking of dupes in general, you could have two products with the exact same ingredient list, but the quality or the sourcing of the ingredients could be very different, or the manufacturing, the way they were stored, or whether or not they were shipped across the nation on a truck versus in an air-conditioned, you know, light temperature controlled sealed container. All of that can greatly impact the final product and how it feels and works on the skin. So while there is no such thing as a perfect dupe, I've tried my best to find alternatives that are going to work similarly to what Tati uses, but for a more budget-friendly price. And yes, all of these are cruelty-free. Additionally, you know that I care about actives. I care about how my skincare is going to work, the cosmetic chemistry behind it, and how it works with the biology of my booty. Not my booty, my beauty. Which could technically include your booty. I mean, who says it doesn't? But in doing that, there are a few products here that have similar ingredients lists and therefore a similar outcome on the skin, but they might have a different texture. For instance, maybe Tati's is more of a cream, whereas this less expensive recommendation might be more of a serum. But let's actually get into that so that you can decide for yourself. The first product that Tati mentions is actually not the most expensive nor the worst. It is from Caudalie, and it is this micellar cleansing water. And again, for $30, this actually isn't half bad. The main ingredients in here are water, glycerin, and a copolymer, which is pretty standard, and kind of some of the key ingredients they like to point to are this grapefruit water that Caudalie is kind of known for. Everything else in here is also not super compelling, seeing as this is just, you know, kind of like a micellar water makeup removal product. We do have grape juice and fragrance, so when searching for a dupe, I wanted something that was less expensive and cruelty-free and had some grape in it, and just got the makeup and the sunscreen and the grease from the day to go away. And boy, did I find one. Instead of $28, I found one for $7 to $8, and it is from Fresh Food for Skin. This is something that you can buy in a pack of one or a pack of two, and the ingredients do what they say they will, as well as having a little bit of a grape moment if that is something that you want sensorially. I haven't tried this product personally, but a lot of the reviews on this product state that it removes makeup really well, it doesn't leave the skin feeling overly irritated, and people really love the scent. When looking at the ingredients, I actually feel like this is an elevated version and has better ingredients than the Caudalie, because not only is this a micellar water to cleanse the skin, but it also says that we have allantoin, which is very soothing, especially to irritated skin. This does have witch hazel, borage, and cornflower extract, and it says it's made for sensitive skin, whereas apparently the Caudalie one might not be. So overall, if you're looking to save money or if you're on a budget and you want something that has the grape extract, the grape scent, but without the $30 price tag, this one is cruelty-free and much less expensive. Now, Tati also also recommended the Burt's Bees option. I actually feel like this one is already drugstore and pretty mass available friendly when it comes to pricing. Personally, when looking at this, I don't love a lot of Burt's Bees products. And if you want a dupe that is a dollar less, I do got you. The Burt's Bees one is $9.99, but I found this one from Garnier that is $8.99. So if you want to save a dollar, then sure. The main ingredient that's similar here is this rose water, but I think the most important thing to mention with this comparison is that Tati likes a lot of these natural, clean, safe branded products. And we know that just because something is natural doesn't mean it's better, doesn't mean it's safer at all. Sometimes it can even be more potent with essential oils and therefore more irritating to the skin. So we discussed that in the reaction video, but just as a caveat here as well, if you don't want to support the Burt's Bees, which is technically owned by Clorox now, I believe, Garnier recently went cruelty-free, which I personally love to see. If you do want some other cleansing options, there are some great ones from the Inky list, like the Oat Cleansing Balm, as well as their, it's a really cool, like, dual phase shaky shaky, really inexpensive and drugstore friendly. And then there's also the Oat Milk Cleansing Latte thing from Sweet Chef, which is owned by Glow Recipe, fun fact. It's like Glow Recipe's little sister. And they as well have a really cool oat cleanser to help remove dirt, makeup, oil, and sunscreen from your face. Next, Tati mentions this brand that I had never heard of before. It's called the Epara Skincare Natural Cleansing Oil for $63. Very expensive, and there are definitely other cleansing oils that I would recommend. What's interesting about this cleansing oil versus others is that the first ingredient isn't, you know, an oil or water, but it's actually glycerin and caprylic triglyceride, which we normally see inside of moisturizers. And when trying to find like a dupe for this that's less expensive, I did find one from beloved Paula's Choice for $25. It's on sale for $21. And the real thing about this is that I wanted to find a cleanser that has a similar texture and consistency and feel. And Paula's Choice is one that actually has, you know, one of these cleansers with a first ingredient of caprylic triglyceride. There are some different plant extracts in this Epara cleansing oil. And for the sensitive skinned individuals, I don't know if that would be that great. What I love about Paula's Choice is that they have like the jojoba, the sunflower, the meadowfoam seed oil, but not a lot of the fragrant plant oils. So if you are sensitive to fragrances, the Paula's Choice is literally less than half the price. And it is, of course, cruelty-free and technically fragrance-free. Now, I also love the Medicube Red Cleansing Oil. This is something I've been loving, although this is much more like an oil cleanser. And then same with the Dermalogica Pre-Cleanse. If you want something that smells really good and does have plant extracts in it, the Dermalogica Pre-Cleanse, it is, again, more of this oil texture, but it is a really good one. Tati brings up the Crave Beauty Matcha Hemp Hydrating Cleanser for $16, and this one, no dupe. This one is amazing. It is already affordable. It is a great formula. I absolutely love this, and I love that Tati mentions it. I don't feel like there is anything comparable to this that's way less expensive. And if anything, I feel like this is a less expensive or dupe version of some much more expensive products. So if you like Lia Yu, if you like Crave Beauty, or if you just want to try this, it is not a bad choice. Tati does mention her supplements as well as some skincare tools. We're going to leave those alone for now. But if you want a deep dive, an ingredient analysis, or anything like that, I am a nutritionist. I am not a dietitian, but I do have an interest in what we feed our bodies and how that plays into our overall health and wellness. So if you have a request, the comments box is open and all yours. Tati then brings out this glycolic Vino Perfect thing from Caudalie again. And of course, when looking at the ingredients, it's like $54. So it's not as bad as some of the other products to come. But I just look at this and I'm like, yeah, I am not paying $54 for this glycolic acid. And it's not cruelty free, which matters to me. Okay, okay. This isn't even that impressive to me. It looks like an essence, and it does have glycolic acid, this small molecular weight AHA that can penetrate into the skin, help with hydration. But then it has a lot of these citrus ingredients, basically. We have that grape, which Caudalie is known for, but we also have this bitter orange, which gives it a bit of a scent, and maybe some potential antioxidant benefits. Now, this also has glycerin. We know and love that as our lovely humectant. It's really soothing to the skin. It holds onto water. And again, it's not a bad product, but guess what I found for half the price? This is the Nude Sticks Citrus Fruit and Glycolic Toner. And this is very comparable when we look at the active ingredients and how they work. I didn't even know Nude Sticks made skincare. I always knew that they had made, you know, a whole bunch of those crayon pencils, but they do skincare now and it doesn't look half bad. This right here is $28 and it does have some very comparable ingredients. We do have the same glycolic acid that exfoliates the skin. And then we do have orange extract, but we also have lime inside of this one, as well as apple and grape, which is kind of that Caudalie key secret ingredient, but I found this to be very, very comparable. Now, both of these do have plant oils. The Nude Sticks one actually has bitter orange and tangerine, so it's more of a full spectrum of orange if you really like that. If you are fragrance sensitive, you're going to want to avoid both of these, but if you're looking to save some money, the Nude Sticks one seems really comparable. And yes, this one does have glycerin as well for those humectant hydrating properties. If you do want something that is fragrance free, the Inky List has a really good glycolic acid toner. The Ordinary does as well. The Ordinary's is much more potent. And then if you are looking for a toner that is hydrating and soothing and doesn't have a lot of acids, the Pyeongkang Yule Essence Toner, it is one of my favorites and it cannot be beat. Now Tati brings out this bad boy. This is the Fresh Kombucha Facial thingy. It's basically this fermented kombucha thing and people love this. And I get it, it's for the brand, it's for the experience, it's because it's a beautiful bottle. But if you're looking at that and you're like, oh, I don't want to have to pay 72 doll hairs for that, but I want to try some fermented skincare on my face. What's a girl supposed to do? You go directly to K-Beauty or to the Cassandra Banks and YouTube channel, and you find yourself some options, specifically from Haru Haru. Haru Haru makes some of my favorite fermented products, and oh my god, they literally have this essence, this fermented essence, that is basically like kombucha in a bottle. And in my opinion, it actually has better ingredients than the fresh one. What's also great is that this used to be in a fragranced version, so they have like this slight lavender fragrance to it, but now they make it in a fragrance-free version as well for those who are more sensitive. The fresh one is $72, whereas the Haru Haru one is $22. When looking at the ingredients, these are not identical dupes, but we do have some similarities, specifically in how hydrating these are and the fact that they both have fermented ingredients. The fresh kombucha one has a Saccharomyces ferment filtrate as well as some glycerin, and it doesn't have hyaluronic acid, but it has the related molecule sodium hyaluronate. Well, guess what our lovely, wonderful $22 Haru Haru Wonders got? It's also got glycerin, aspergillus extract, as well as hyaluronic acid. So not the sister molecule, but like the actual thing. The ingredients in this Haru Haru one are actually, again, better in my personal opinion. We've also got a rice extract in here. We've got a bark extract. It is fermented. And just based on the price, the texture, the experience, I love this one way better. And fresh is not cruelty free, whereas Haru Haru is. I am obsessed with this line, and if you are even thinking about fermented skincare, don't do the fresh kombucha. Do the Haru Haru Wonder and allow it to do wonders for your skin. Tati brings out another serum, and this one was actually interesting. It is again from Fresh, and it is the Rose Deep Hydration Oil Infused Serum. Now, I wasn't able to find an exact dupe. This oil infused serum is definitely a serum-y texture. Tati really loves it, but it is expensive, it's not cruelty free, and a lot of the ingredients I was able to find from lovely Glossier. And instead of having to pay $59, the Glossier one is $24. This is the Future Dew from Glossier, and let's actually compare the ingredients lists to see if any of those more active ingredients are going to have an impact on the skin. Some of the ingredients in this Fresh Deep Hydration Serum are really focused around this rose as well as this squalane. It's a great oil that our skin naturally produces, but it's also really good when you put it in products. This also has glycerin and tocopherol to really support and hydrate the skin, and inside of this Glossier one, yes, we have some of the same as well as similar ingredients. Specifically, we do have glycerin and squalane. Now, these are higher up on the ingredients list in the Glossier one, so I assume that the Glossier is going to be a little bit thicker. So obviously there are different amounts of this in the Glossier one, but that's why I actually like the Glossier one better, because you're getting a higher percentage of those really beneficial ingredients. But the Glossier also has tocopherol, and it actually has multiple kind of rosy and flowery oils. We have evening primrose oil, we do have rose fruit oil, we also have grape, etc. For the price, I find these to be really good. I like the Glossier one and the way it looks and feels better. Is the fresh one horrible? Not per se. I really like the oil in serum kind of concept, but I don't think that you should have to spend that much money for it. And personally, I don't vibe with it because it is not cruelty free. And you know that that is important to me. Then we go to Revision Skincare, which is insanely priced. This product that Tati holds up is $133. And I get it. We love luxury. We love to feel good. Tati is known for her luxury reviews. But when I look at that for $133, I understand some of the ingredients in this line actually do merit the price. But if you don't have that kind of money to spend, you shouldn't have to. This is the Revision Skincare Vitamin C Lotion 30% Daily Antioxidant for Brighter Skin with THD Ascorbate. And this THD Ascorbate, this tetrahexyldecyl ascorbate, is really this hero vitamin C product that, yes, does cost a lot of money, and it is a nice stabilized version of vitamin C. It's also oil soluble. It's really good for the skin. It is a little bit more expensive, so I get that. But guess what? I found something for $60 instead of $133. You are saving yourself more than half of the price, okay? The Covay next up, it's like a vitamin C serum, is $59. I know that this is a celebrity brand, but I've actually tried this vitamin C and I love it. This is a really good one. And again, THD ascorbate is oil soluble, so it really works on my oily acne prone skin. It is stabilized, it is beautiful. And I love this Covay one, and I'm like, why would you wanna pay twice the price? There are some slight differences, and in the Revision Skincare, if you look further down the list, you do see some really good antioxidants like ubiquinone, which is known as CoQ10 or coenzyme Q10. But for the price, I think that the Covay one is really similar and it is cruelty-free. So if you don't want to spend that money on the Revision one, you don't have to. Now, if that's not worth a like and a subscribe, I don't know what is. By the way, I know that this is a lot of ingredient analysis as well as some fun skincare stuff. So we've actually got an entire blog post up that compares these side by side and actually creates an inexpensive, affordable, vegan, and cruelty-free skincare routine for Tati in written form. So if you want that, it is the first link right there. You're very welcome. That took time too. I hope you like it. I hope you enjoy. We are proud. We are very, very proud here. But it doesn't stop here with the Revision Skincare. There is another $134 product that, yes, I found an alternative for. This Revision Skincare product is the Nectrafirm Advanced Next Generation technology for a younger looking neck and décolleté. And I don't think you've heard me bitch about neck creams, but I hate them almost as much as I hate eye creams, because eye creams are overpriced moisturizers. And guess what neck creams are? Firming moisturizers that are also overpriced. You can totally use your literal face moisturizer as a neck cream. But I will admit, this brand does have some very interesting ingredients. Like, they have done their research and development. I respect that. But you don't have to spend $133 for a good neck cream, aka overpriced moisturizer. If you were going to spend money on something, this does have a lot of great ingredients. We have polysaccharides, we have a bunch of different peptides, we have some anti-wrinkle stuff, but a lot of the key ingredients I was able to find in a cruelty-free, much less expensive version. K-Beauty comes to the rescue again on this one, and instead of $133 something, just chop $100 off of that. We've got an option for $33.40. It is from a brand that I've never actually heard of or tried before. This is called MediPeel. It is vegan and cruelty-free, and it is the Pore 9 Tight Serum. And although it looks like this might be a different consistency, what I really care about here are these active ingredients matching up. When it comes to ingredients like algae and ceramides and peptides and green tea, these can be very, very expensive, but also very, very good for the skin. Thankfully, this K-Beauty product has a lot of these similar ingredients for literally $100 less. Let's dive in here, because both of these do have algae, great to fight that reactive oxygen species damage that comes from just living from day to day. We've also got green tea, which is an amazing antioxidant and has skin support, as well as ceramides, which you know our skin naturally produces, but a little bit more can actually help with wrinkles, with fine lines, with plumping, and supporting our skin's barrier. Now, the $133 Tati one does have a tripeptide 38. This has been found to be wound healing, collagen stimulating, it helps with wrinkle reduction, etc. And unfortunately, the palmital tripeptide 38 is not found in this K-Beauty one, but we do have other peptides in here which do act as cellular signaling, and based on, you know, manufacturer claims or preliminary research, can support some of these downstream actions that could lead to wrinkle reduction or collagen stability. If you have $133 to spend, okay, fine, go for it. But if you're on a budget and you're looking for something that is a little bit more affordable, you want the goods without having to pay for all of the goodies, this one seems like a really cool K-Beauty option. And again, I haven't tried this one personally, so I am adding this to cart. Tati holds these up. These are these peel pads from Indie Lee. And I actually like Indie Lee. I think she's got a great brand. I love the founder's story. I've had the chance to speak with her before, and I really like that she stands by what she creates. But simultaneously, when you look at these peel pads, these are not interesting to me. These are $65, and the main ingredients are denatured alcohol, very drying. We have witch hazel, which I don't hate, but I really don't love here. We've got propandiol. Then we've got some salicylic acid, which is oil soluble and helps with acne. We do love that. But then they litter it with a bunch of plant oils like tangerine. I'm like, okay, why? And then it's $65. Like denatured alcohol pads with salicylic acid for $65. If you want some alcohol pads, guess what Tayers has for $9.99. Now, actual moment here, I actually believe this Tayers one is better than the Indie Lee because not only does it not have the denatured alcohol, it's just the witch hazel, but it has aloe vera, which is slightly more soothing, and it's missing a lot of those, you know, ridiculous plant ingredients that really don't do a lot of benefit to the skin. This Tayers one has witch hazel, it does have tea tree, which we know is antimicrobial, and yes, it's got salicylic acid. And I feel that this is less drying, it is less irritating, although it is still not for sensitive skin, and it's $9 with a salicylic acid witch hazel base that I feel is comparable, if not much better, than the $65 Indie Lee one. Again, Indie Lee has some decent products, but this is not one of them. And I get that Tati wants the all natural. I feel like Tayers brands themselves as natural. This is a much better option. And if you want like a glycolic option, like an AHA instead of a BHA, April Skin has a good one. There are many other brands, even Dr. Zenobia, if you want to pay a little bit more, she has one that's made for hormonal acne. And it sounds like that's what Tati uses it for, is kind of like this, I want my skin to look better immediately kind of thing. I just wouldn't pay $65 for it. Literally, Dr. Sandra Lee MD, Dr. Zenobia, or if you want to go cheap, Tayers. Have at it, my friends. Then for $68, Tati whips out the Tatcha Water Cream. And this is a good product. It is cruelty-free, but it is very expensive for what it is. And you're basically paying for that cute little bottle and the little spoony dispenser. Now, there are a lot of claimed dupes online. We're talking about things like the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Cream. If you're talking about texture, even the Make Prem is one that I recommend because it is cruelty-free. It has a very similar texture, and I love Make Prem products. But when it comes to actually finding a dupe for the ingredients, it is difficult. The Tatcha one does have gold, which I don't understand why that's in there. And they actually have mica, which is what actually gives it that shimmery look. Tatcha claims that this is pore tightening. I don't see a lot in there that really backs that up. But I mean, as a moisturizer with some glitter, yeah, I guess you could diffuse light and make your pores look smaller, make your skin look smoother, I suppose. The Tatcha one does have this Saccharomyces ferment, which it does cost a lot of money, so I get it. But K-Beauty comes to the rescue, and Dear Claire's writes my wall it a love note and seduces my digital wallet Apple Pay and literally gives us an option for a fraction of the price, because of course that's what Dear Claire's does. Of course that's what K-Beauty does. K-Beauty is like the knight in shining armor that comes to rescue Rapunzel from the freaking tower, like riding a white stallion. Like that is what K-Beauty is. It's affordable, it's accessible, really good ingredients, usually cruelty-free because animal testing is illegal in Korea. We love. This Dear Claire's Fundamental Water Gel Cream is $31, so literally half of the price, and the ingredients are impeccable. Both of these have Camellia sensis leaf or Camellia sensis leaf extract. This is essentially green tea. And they are both high up on the ingredient list, meaning that we get a huge boost of antioxidants and skin support. We've also got rice extract in both of these. For Tatcha, it's the rice ferment filtrate. And the Dear Claire's one is a rice extract, but still we're getting those hydrating beneficial ingredients. The Tatcha one has sodium hyaluronate, and then the Dear Claire's one has hyaluronic acid. And again, this is another case where I actually kind of like the Dear Claire's one better. You know that I really hate these skincare brands that claim that it's their skincare making your skin look good, but it's like makeup disguised as skincare. And for the Tatcha, because it has this gold and this mica, any shimmery kind of luminosity that you're seeing in the skin, it's not the product making your skin look luminous long term, it's the product adding like makeup or glitter. And when you wash that off, the results will go away. And does it look good while you're wearing it? Totally. But I dislike that. I'm not a fan. I want my skincare to be actives and do skincare, not just like fluff. And again, Tatcha is very fun, but it is very fluff. This Dear Claire's one doesn't have all that, and it actually has ingredients like jojoba, which my skin personally loves. This Dear Claire's one looks amazing for your skin barrier. It looks dewy and supportive and phenomenal. And again, this is one that I have added to cart. I've used a lot of Dear Claire's products that I have fallen in love with. And for 30 something bucks, it's half the price of Tatcha. You don't get the cool little spoon doohickey thing, but you know, you can buy those little spoon doohickeys for like 8 to 12 bucks online, and then you're at $40. And then you're still saving almost half the cost of what Tatcha is selling. And then Tati pulls out an eye cream, and this eye cream, I can't. It's a fresh eye cream, and it's supposed to have this black tea. The main ingredients in here that are actually kind of standing out to me are actually blackberry. We don't often see blackberry extract in a lot of products. and it is cool to see blackberry in this one,
but not for $68.
We've also got green tea in this fresh one, and overall, this is an overpriced moisturizer. Like, if you look at those main ingredients, that is basically what you find in a moisturizer, only they're charging you way more and telling you to put it under your eyes, and they're selling it to you in something this big. By big, I mean ridiculously tiny. Now, I searched online to find an option, and this happens to be from a brand called Shira, and you'll notice that this is not an eye cream, this is a moisturizer. Because what are eye creams? They are overpriced moisturizers that you could put literally anywhere on your face. Now, this Shira one is amazing. It not only has this really high concentration of blackberry extract and green tea, but it actually has ingredients that we're not even finding in the fresh, you know, eye cream one. We have coenzyme Q10, we have vitamin E. We have other skin supportive ingredients like alpha lipoic acid and vitamin C for brightening, and the fresh one doesn't have that at all. And yes, this is a face moisturizer, but it's $20, so way less in price, and you're getting way more of it because it's marketed as a face moisturizer and not an eye cream. And you can literally put this all around the eye area, not to mention this doesn't have fragrance, so it is probably a little bit better for those who do have a sensitive eye area. Obviously, you don't get it in the conjunctiva inside of the eye, but oh my god, this is such a great option. It has those same hero ingredients of blackberry and green tea that the fresh one does, and it's literally way less of a price, and of course, cruelty-free. It is kind of rare to find blackberry in skincare, but it's not impossible, and hey, you can save money while doing it. I hate eye creams, and if you've been here, you know this, and if you haven't been here, welcome to the family. Consider joining, sharing, sending to a friend, and hitting the like button. But we bitch about eye creams all the time, and there are very few eye creams that I actually recommend. And as long as you understand that they're overpriced moisturizers, and you know that you're wasting your money, and you know what actual eye condition you're trying to treat, fine, go for it. But there are very few I recommend, such as the retinaldehyde one from Michel, such as the Purito one, which is pretty good. There's also a retinol one from the Inky List. That is where I stand on eye creams, and we have a whole video bitching about them. Then Tati brings out this Epura something, $147. Face mask. And this $147 face mask does have some decent ingredients, but I don't see why these are worth $147. Again, good ingredients like licorice, like rice. We've even got kaolin, which is really good to kind of mattify and wick oil away. But then you also have things like frankincense, and I'm like, okay, is that why you're charging an arm and a leg for this? Like, it's sold at Saks Fifth Avenue. Like, okay, fine, be bougie. But if you want to spend less money, I found something that is not only less expensive, vegan, and cruelty-free, but has all of the same hero ingredients, and it's actually a powder that you mix your own water into. So you're getting more bang for your buck, and then because it is sold in a powdered form, you're actually saving money and the environment by using a powdered skincare instead of something that already has water pre-mixed in. And of course, there are some formulas that you're going to need to buy with water. Water is the most common skincare ingredient, and it is the universal solvent. But if we don't need that, especially for a face mask, like fucking why pay $147 for it? This one is called Cleansing Grains. It's $26. Now, it is called the Geisha Cleanse. I don't understand this brand. This is my first time I'm seeing it. But yes, looking at the ingredients, I would pay for this. I'm hoping that this actually does something to benefit Japanese culture instead of just saying Geisha Cleanse, but we can leave that analysis for another day. When you actually look at the ingredients here, we have a main ingredient of rice powder. We then have oat kernel powder. We have that exact same kaolin clay. We do have some bentonite clay, which is an added bonus. Now, there is some pumice powder, which I don't always love, but it looks pretty good inside of this formula. And then the real kicker here is this licorice. We know that licorice is amazing for hyperpigmentation, for brightening the skin, and from stopping the skin from creating this pigment that can kind of stick around and hang around unevenly. And both of these products have it. So if you can get the rice, the licorice, and the kaolin clay in both products, you're forgoing some of the fancy frankincense oil. I mean, for $26 instead of $147, this is a no-brainer for me. And overall, just like for masks in general, I don't even really recommend either of these. Yeah, they're decent, but I would recommend more targeted face masks. Like Bubble has a great one, Juice Beauty has a great one. Like, there are other face masks that are much less expensive that actually do more for the skin. And if you're trying to fight hyperpigmentation, I wouldn't do that in a mask. I would get a licorice serum or a vitamin C licorice niacinamide toner, like what we can get from Good Molecules that is packaged in a glass container. And if you have $147, you can do whatever you would like with them, but I just would not spend my money on this. Then Tati mentioned something that speaks directly to my pimply heart, which is a Dapolene gel. She holds up different, which is amazing. It is drugstore, it is inexpensive, it is effective, and I love that she uses this. This is already a really affordable option that has been medically proven because it used to be a prescription that helps out with acne blemishes and acne prone skin. Now, what I would personally recommend is Acne Free. Acne Free is actually a couple dollars less for the same amount of different. It has the same active ingredient, which is a Dapolene gel, and Acne Free is also cruelty free, which does matter a ton to me. Both of these are really good options, and I'm so grateful that Tati mentions this. She also mentions that she uses it as like a spot treatment. I would actually personally recommend using this all over because a Dapolene gel can be used as a spot treatment, but it not only helps to prevent acne if you use it all over, but it also helps with making your dermis thicker. So collagen, elastin, support, and actually proliferation. And then on top of that, it can help with wrinkles and fine lines. And if you're just spotting that on, you're not getting all those benefits. Whereas if you put it all over, it actually prevents acne from happening in the future. And then it is giving you all of these benefits that we know and love our retinoids for. Tati mentions some tools, and oh boy, fun with tools. But you know what pisses me off? She doesn't mention sunscreen. Tati, what sunscreen? Come on, help me out here. We gotta be working with something. We've done an entire video on different sunscreens based on white cast. We've done many, many sunscreen reviews and actually ranking videos. And again, I know that Tati wants like a more natural form of sunscreen, so I'm assuming she wants a mineral one. Mineral or inorganic sunscreens are known for being a little bit white casty, a little bit pasty and having some flashback. But there are some that I found that are really, really, really excellent. And again, we ranked those all in a video. Now we could sit here and tell Tati to wear sunscreen and get her to use some of our favorites, but that video already exists on the internet. And this video is already very long. Again, this took multiple people, lots of research, and lots of scrounging the internet for affordable, cruelty-free, inexpensive, and effective skincare products. So if you would like to show your appreciation with a like or a share, or just by joining the Beautiful Butterfly community, you are always welcome here. If you were given just a ridiculous amount of money, like if I were to magically wave a genie wizard Harry Potter wand and say, you can choose any one of Tati's expensive products and I will pay for it, which one would it be? I would love to know. And are there any of these dupes that you are going to pick up? Because I've already got some K-Beauty in my cart. Either way, do remember to stay hydrated, both by drinking water and applying something good on your face today, as well as reapplying your sunscreen and being beautiful both inside and out. I love you, and I cannot wait to see you in this next video. Love you guys. Bye.